Great to have you here and great to have alumni here. So tell us a little bit about the project. The project is called the Refugee First Response Center. So what is the idea?
So actually the idea started in our community neighborhood in Hamburg, you know, where we came together as some friends trying to fight the refugee crisis. And we thought about how can technology help refugees in that case, right? Bringing entrepreneurs, global tech players like Cisco, research academia, right? Exponential thinkers like Harald together, and we came to the idea to build telemedicine into something just talk, which is mobile, which you can bring everywhere, and a container. We have a lot of containers in Hamburg, right? And we also brought a medical station in there, and we also brought in 750 translators who do speak collectively 50 plus languages by just the press of a button. We have been able to pitch this to my management team. And then actually what happens usually in large corporations, and Salim pointed that out earlier in the morning, the automatic immune system started. The question, you know, tell me the business case. You know, what is the business case? How do you want to scale this across Europe? How many of these containers do you want to sell? We don't really sell containers. And then that was kind of no. Of course, we didn't accept it a no. And then we submitted the idea, this slide, literally into a internal WhatsApp room. 600 people were sharing what they are doing in helping to fight the refugee crisis and donating clothes and so on. And I got caught by a European leader saying, Mirko, we like the project, we want to make it happen, let's do it. And then after 6 weeks, just from idea to execution, to live implementation, we did it. We have a video with us, 2 minutes, yes. 45, shows how we did it. Please roll the video.
How did you launch it? That's what we want to know. There we go.
So it's literally a basic container, two windows, a door, and we got in there putting a network in there, 150 meters of cabling, 16 Cat6 sockets, and then we asked the doctors, you know, how you want to have a medic station in a container? What do we need? Cupboards, bench, and so on. They helped us to do that thing. And then on the 2nd of November, we brought this to a refugee reception where I live, 10 minutes around my home, around the corner, at my doorsteps, where do live 1,000 people in a former Max Bar do-it-yourself home market. It's operated by the German Red Cross, and the doctors are from the University Hospital in Eppendorf, so they also have a research mission. That's why they granted us to get in there. And you see that there is one area for nursing, for first primary care, and there's the area in the back end, which is more for the doctor.
Behind us, we have a container, a standard 20 feet sea container. That container is equipped with free Wi-Fi access for all the doctors, free Wi-Fi access for the refugees. But also we are providing video interpretation services where we have access to 750 interpreters being able to translate 50 languages within 120 seconds if you click it.
Wir sind sehr zufrieden mit dem Service, weil die Sprache praktisch der Schlüssel für die Kommunikation natürlich ist und wir müssen mit diesen Menschen und Patienten in erster Linie kommunizieren, um herauszufinden, wo liegt das Problem. Viele Probleme liegen im psychosozialen Bereich, was ja verständlich ist. Und die werden dann organisch präsentiert hier bei uns. Und wir müssen herausfinden, ob wir jetzt organische Diagnostik, also CT und Labor machen, oder ob die Patienten oder Menschen eben eher traumatisiert sind und psychosoziale Unterstützung benötigen.
Es gibt unheimlich viele Mutmaßungen darüber, was Flüchtlinge brauchen, was die medizinischen Bedarfe sind. Da gibt es ganz viele Ideen viele Spekulationen, aber wenig klare Daten. Und diese Daten wollen wir erheben.
Salam alaikum. Hallo, shama khube. Mushkile shama chie? Maris hasti.
Great project.
Thanks.
So tell us some numbers. You have some statistics yet, or where are you in the phase right now?
Yes, so since 2nd of November, since we are in operational mode, we had almost 3,000 video medication calls, And we know that it was around 62% Farsi, so people who do join us from Iran, Iraq, Afghanistan, mm-hmm. around 20% from Syria, so Arabic. And then we had more than 10% coming from Tigrinya. You ever heard about the language Tigrinya? So people joining us from Eritrea and Ethiopia, and then some minor languages. Right now you see Serbia, Croatia, and so on. And the interesting thing is that you see all the different languages. And so where we see this also has a kind of a massive transformative purpose, because if you do know what kind of languages you need, where, which time, you can of course scale your stuff on demand. So this is a kind of an Uber. You hit the, press the button, the magic happens. It's not the taxi arriving, it's the translator arriving. So you can call it an Uber Setzer. That's simply basically it.
Which is, I think, fantastic idea. So how is this inspired by Singularity University, Harald? You're an alumni as well.
Yeah, I was there 2012, and I'm a fan since 2010. And I think it's something yesterday. This is sort of a spontaneous idea, 6 years in the making. Because as you saw in the video, I have a container shipping campus, if you will, as a co-working space. But I think we all can, wherever we are, can apply our whether we're a tech player, whether we're an entrepreneur, we can apply our talent for the grand challenges and really say, now we can do something for health or communication. Right. Even though you think you sell Wi-Fi, and I think a lot of people think they cannot do anything because I'm part of a big corporation or I'm just too small as a startup, but I think either the combination or thinking big and bold, and that's, I think, what we learned at CU.
Absolutely. And where do you want to go from here? Like, this is like, how do you want to scale it up?
You
plan to do it, right?
Yes, of course. So we have the first unit live and operating, and it's actually close to 4,000 exams we already did. Now the Otto Foundation actually helped us with a donation of 10 units, so we go bigger in a little bit of a pro. So this June we'll have 10 units in Hamburg live operating, and now we want to go 100x. So my dream is to really bring 100 of these containers down south between Hamburg, Berlin, and Lesbos, or even going down to Turkey. And that's, I think, we should try to do this.
I think it's amazing. So how can the community help? Like SU community, and now we have this distinguished group of people that will go back and they can say, well, we're part of this community now. How can they help?
I think, right now, obviously, this, let's say, bring 100 of these containers is about maybe 5 million euros. So obviously, we seek some funding, but similar, we try to reach out again to Cisco and see if they can help us with in-kind, all of the hardware which is in there. But if you have any ideas of any kind of fixtures, transportation, communication, access to NGOs and medical staff and so on, we would be grateful. Really see there's a lot of amazing people here, and you can have an impact or help us make something and scale this from a, European impact entrepreneurship and bring it out to the world.
Great project, great idea to action. Thanks, guys, for coming, and thanks for sharing this fantastic idea.